good evening. Welcome to our second Ragamuffin Movie Night here on Ragamuffin Archive. I'm Joe Cook, and tonight we've got a real treat. We're going to be showing the 2015 concert film Mitch McVicker live in Morton, and even more fun, Mitch is going to be joining us for this special watch party. Right now, here he is. Mitch, how you doing, man?
Doing good. Thanks, Joe. Thanks for having me.
Oh, man, this is great. I really appreciate you taking time to do this. I've been following your touring schedule. And, dude, I think you do more dates than Dylan. Like,
well, you know, that is a high compliment for me. He calls what he does the never ending tour, and I can resonate with that. I don't know when my touring season is other than all the time.
Man, I get exhausted just like looking at your schedule. let me ask you a little bit about that. Like, because you've been doing this for more than a quarter century now. So what is it about what you do that keeps you doing what you do?
Well, I love it. That's probably the biggest thing. It's a great passion of mine. It's who I am. It's what I do. And I love getting to communicate with people. When you make up songs, of course, you want to share them with people. And I love getting to communicate with people and try and point them towards something of purpose, trying to point them towards a God that is way bigger than our minuscule life that we live, though it's touched by God and therefore great. So it's fun. Joe, the answer is I don't know what else I would or could do.
Fair enough. you know what, man, though? And it's the thing about it is it's such a fun show that you do. I mean, it's always a pleasure when I hear that you're coming to town. And I'm sure many of the people watching us tonight have seen you in concert, but I'm sure some probably haven't. And so I think the Live in Morton thing is going to be a lot of fun for those folks, because the Mitch McVicker concert experience is pretty unique. I mean, it really is. And I've seen other artists who kind of, you do this looping thing. And I've seen other artists do looping, but not quite in the way you do looping. Can you explain to everybody, if they haven't seen you, what that is and what they're going to be seeing in the movie tonight?
Yeah, it basically, the concert area, the stage or the performance area, looks kind of like a garage sale. I have a table full of sundry household items, junk, children's toys, and I use them as percussion instruments and create a loop, and you see it all happen. Each concert is a new adventure. I never know how it's going to come together, how it's going to be. I just have to roll with it. And that's kind of exciting for me. I kind of do concerts as a spiritual growth experience, because that's what life is. It's an adventure that never goes quite as we planned, and we don't really know what lies ahead. But we roll with it. So it will be, I think the film was recorded a number of years ago, but this is how it was that particular night. And so that's very representative of what it is each time I do a concert. That's how it is that particular night.
You know what? It is interesting because I've seen you a number of times over the years, and I've been there on nights where everything seemingly went without a hitch. And then I went to one show where the whole system went down like mid-show. And but that was one of my favorite shows, because then you had, like, you know, you just had to pivot, and it was exciting and it was fun, and it's always a great experience. I'm sure it was a lot more fun for me than it was for you.
it is cool, like I said, to go through those pivots and figure out how we continue to go, So that's a good experience, though. Yes, the anxiety arises within you, but when does that not happen in life?
You know what? I've never asked you, and I've always kind of wondered this. And how did you like stumble into the idea of doing the whole looping toys and household objects thing?
Yeah, I saw. You know, a lot of people are familiar with folks like Phil Keaggy and stuff that loop their guitar, their various instruments. And then I noticed that the looping pedal has a mic input. And so I thought, you know, I had various guys play with me as a band for about 10 years, and life would take people in different directions. And I got somewhat tired of rebuilding the band and, you know, bringing in a new 3-4 guys. And so I thought, you know what, I can do this myself, but how do I drive it? So I decided to get this looping pedal and just use the mic input and just basically just beatbox a beat into it. And then one time I had a water bottle or a can of Diet Coke on, and I picked it up and I hit it into the beat, and I saw people's eyes light up. And then I was like, okay, it's on. I'm picking the weirdest stuff I can find and I'll create loops using that stuff.
Well, man, we're going to talk more about the concert, especially the Morton concert, in a few minutes, but I wanted to talk to you about this Kickstarter campaign you're doing. You've got a new project that you're going to be working on. You launched a Kickstarter a few weeks back. Man, like, tell me about this, because how do you approach a new project? Like, how do you know you're ready? Because I think this is what, like, you've done like 13 or 14 albums now, right?
Yeah, and that's, once you start to accumulate albums at that number, you just begin to feel old. But that it's what, like I said, it's what I do. And so at concerts, I have a merch table with the album spread out there, and it just becomes like, you know, looking at old yearbooks, you know, pictures through the years. I don't know exactly how you determine that it's time, other than songs are always happening for me as I drive, as I sound check, whatever's rolling through my mind, whatever I'm paying attention to outside of me, inside of me, begins to form itself into a song as I work at it and construct it. And another factor is, you know, like you said, I've been doing this for a long time. And when I go back to a place after a year or two, they want another album, you know? So I am happy to oblige, and it just requires putting it all together. And I have, like I was talking to you earlier today on the phone, I have a few, you know, a handful, 4 or 5 songs that are done. And then I have another 30 that are in the works, you know, to one degree or another. And so you craft those and work on them and see if they become anything. And that's kind of my roundabout process of how I get ready for an album.
You know what occurred to me maybe a week or so ago, and I don't know how this had never occurred to me until now, but I read just how many albums you'd made, and I think it was mentioned in your Kickstarter or on the video or something. And when I realized it was that many, it kind of freaked me out, because I thought, and I was talking to a mutual friend, Chris Marchand. I said, you know, do you realize that Mitch has made like 5 more albums than Rich Mullins now? Like, and like, which makes sense, because your career has been a lot longer than Rich's was. But when I realized that, it made me feel really old.
Yeah, and that was a weird realization to come to a number of years ago, because I always, forever, I will look up to Rich, and now that I am older than he ever was, now that I've done way more concerts than he ever did, now that I've done way more albums than he've ever done, that is a weird spot to be in. But it's inevitable as you do this. It happens, and I'm grateful for the result of doing it after a number of years. And like I said, I don't know what else I would or could do.
You know, what can you tell us about this project? I know obviously you're still in the process of crafting and writing the songs. You've got about half of the record ready. But as far as like, have you thought about, you know, who's going to make it, where you're going to go, who's going to produce it, what studio, or have you been thinking about those things?
Yeah. Those are all pretty set. I'm going to record it at my two favorite studios I've ever worked at. I'm going to record it in two different places. One is in Wellington, Kansas, Green Jeans Studios, which I've used.
You did a lot. You've done a lot of albums there. Yeah.
Yeah. And that's a great place. And then my last recording I did was at Chief Lemon Studios in Indiana. And that was a wonderful experience. So, and they, both those places kind of come at it from different angles. And I wanted to capture both of those and see if we could put something together that kind of meets in the middle, where the raw meets the real, efficient and so yes, that is, been thought about, and you know, the recording is still kind of untitled, the album. I'm throwing out a few, or I'm tossing around, I should say, a few titles in my mind, and it generally makes itself obvious as the recording is in process. I've done, like you said, 12 or 13 albums, and sometimes they have a title before I ever start. Sometimes they have a title that evolves, and this is definitely an evolving title. I'm thinking about right now possibly calling it The Wayfaring Sojourn, because this is a journey. We are on a journey, and I feel that this album is reflective of the journey that I've had, and the journey that I am yet to in experience, but we are all at that point. And so could be songs that reflect that, and blah blah blah.
Well, you know what, I want to talk to you for a minute just about Rich Mullins, because, you know, and I think it relates to the Kickstarter in a way. For one, I mean, obviously, it is no secret to you that, you know, the name Mitch McVicker is kind of synonymous with Rich Mullins. It's, you know, I think that there's a lot of people when they think of Mitch, they go back and they think of Rich and your connection with him. He really helped, you know, start your music career. And then also, obviously, you were in the accident with Rich. You released a Kickstarter video with this campaign where you talked quite a bit about Rich, which I don't really recall you doing that quite as much in the past as you did with this campaign. And so I was just kind of wondering, you know, what you've been feeling lately there, you know, now that, you know, you, after 25 years plus of touring and making records, just looking back at that time, like, what about it do you feel like you're taking into this record, and why?
Well, this particular time for me, it's, you know, people would ask me about, the experience with Rich and the accident, and they were like, how have you dealt with that? How have you dealt with the grief and stuff? And that must have been such a hard, difficult time. And it's kind of twofold, because I was trying to recover myself. Yeah. and wonder what was ever going to happen with me, trying to get back from, you know, the various and sundry things of being in a coma, collapsed lungs, being in the hospital for a long time. And so I was dealing with that. And I have no memory for 6 weeks prior to the wreck or 6 weeks after the wreck. And talking to neuropsychologists and stuff at that particular time, they said, you know, well, it will make sense if you don't really ever grieve, like a lot of people that are looking at this from the outside. And so because and then I had he's a theology professor in at Fuller Seminary out in California, and he said he said, you know, it's no, you're not going to go through the same thing as other people because the day after the wreck, you know, everybody, they just went to the grocery store and continued with their days. That's not your situation.
Yeah.
There hasn't been a day that I haven't dealt with it. There hasn't been a day. You know, in the rush of, it seems like about once every 5 years, there's a rush of capitalizing on Rich's death with various things that happen. And I've always kind of been somewhat closed mouthed about my connection with Rich while acknowledging it in every concert that I do. And like you said, being in the same sentence as Rich, which is a great honor. I thought, you know what? I have somewhat of a connection here, and somewhat is both minimizing it and looking at it realistically. Because Rich was a vast person with vast connections. But I had a close relationship with him for a few years, and was in an extremely significant experience for him, obviously, and for myself, and for Christendom in general, with the wreck. But I thought it's time for me to address this a little bit more than I have in the past, because honestly, I do feel a little bit of a, you know, a little bit of a twinge inside me when there's various people capitalizing on Rich's death, you know, you just go, okay, why is this happening, other than the fact, I mean, we all know the great impact that Rich has had, and it's cool that people that do not know Rich and do not know really anything about his music up until the time that it becomes profitable for them to know, are doing stuff, because I'm all about Rich's impact being made still, but I just thought it's time for me to say more,
kind of in a way, like sort of more publicly claim your place in the story.
Yeah, and I know a little bit of that is gonna to people is gonna reek of ego, but it's also somewhat legitimate.
I don't think it, you know, I think it's very legitimate, and I'll just say this, because I certainly don't want to hijack things and make things about me, but I've been doing Ragamuffin Archive for 14 years now, and I spent 4 years out on the Navajo reservation, and I've done Rich Mullins tribute concerts, and I've done podcasts, and I produced a Rich Mullins live album last year. And all that to say, you mentioned the every 5 years thing. I've coined a phrase that I just call it Rich Mullins burnout. And every 5 years I hit that place where, like, I just can't talk about Rich Mullins right now. And I love Rich. It's not really, Rich didn't do anything. It's just, I'm experiencing this overwhelming, like, headache of all the everything surrounding. It becomes almost kind of chaotic and overwhelming. And it just absolutely, I feel like I have nowhere near, like we're not even in the same category as far as like your connection to Rich, but I feel like I'm losing my identity at some point during, you know, the madness of certain years, which are always, you know, of course, I mean, we're talking about the anniversary of his death years, which are, you know, mm-hmm. tend to be, you know, 2017 and 2022 or whatever. They were exhausting years for me. And I have to imagine that for you, that there's a similar thing that happens there. I'm only bringing this up because I have to imagine there are days like we're sitting here, we're talking about your Kickstarter. We're getting ready to play your concert. And here we are talking about Rich Mullins. And like, I have to like wonder, like, does that get old sometimes? Or they're just like, do you ever just wish you had a day where like, I just wish, man, I just hope Joe doesn't ask me about Rich today.
Well, it's, you know, do I get tired of it from time to time? Yeah. Yeah, I do. Does it mean that I shouldn't talk about it? No. Like I said before, I'm grateful to be included in any discussions about Rich. I'm grateful to have gotten my start because of Rich. I wouldn't be doing this if it wasn't for him. There's a whole bunch of things that we do in life that are good that we are tired of when we are doing them, you know. So it's a little bit of it's that thing that we all go through, letting go of ourselves and taking a hold of who we are.
Exactly. And that's why I'm on here tonight wearing my Rich Mullins baseball cap talking to you. Because the thing about Ragamuffin Archive is I've always felt like, you know, yeah, obviously we want to honor Rich. I mean, Rich made a huge impact in my life, but beyond that, I mean, like, I, you know, I didn't know who Rich was until after he died. And so for me, like, it was always guys like you and Rick Elias and Jimmy and the Ragamuffins, like, that to me, they were my introduction to that music. You know, I heard Rick Elias sing, you know, Rich Mullins songs before I ever heard Rich sing them. And so to me, it's always, I've always wanted to honor all of you guys for the work that you've done on your own and in honor of Rich. And so I'm, you know, and whenever you announce a new Kickstarter campaign, I'm excited because, man, we get new Mitch McVicker music. And I'm so glad you're doing this. And I'm so glad that, you know, I know it's got to be exhausting to be on your never ending tour. But man, like I got to say, on a selfish note, man, I'm happy you're out there doing it. And I know a lot of other people are too. And speaking of new music, can we hear a song from the new record?
I can do a song. Yeah, I am. I'm trusting that the sound is going to work out. And, but I came to the realization that I needed to do this song. I was, somewhere and I saw this little religious track that somebody has strategically placed, you know, and I didn't even pick it up and read it because the cover, on the front cover of the little pamphlet, it said, "Do you know that a king would die for you? Do you know that a king would die for you?" And then it had this picture of this crown that was gold plated, filled with jewels, so ornate and elaborate, and I was like, is that something that Jesus would wear? It just hit me as like a ton of bricks. I was like, it seems like Jesus came to communicate to us a completely different way other than trusting in this wealth and this fanciness and this achieving a great standing with wealth that we think will get us power. It seems like Jesus would be wearing anything but that, and that was his message, to show us a different way. But it seems like we have kind of taken that message back from Jesus and said, no, this is what you meant, Jesus. You should be wearing something like this. And so that's where this came from. There are no jewels in his crown. There is no gold anywhere around him. He was a king, but he loved and served. So we tried to kill him, and he rose from the earth. So sing it, yeah, sing it out. Oh. Sing it out from the bottom of your heart, from the bottom of your soul. Let it go, let it flow. Sing glory, glory, glory. Yeah. The light, it shines bright. Oh, it goes to show there are no jewels in his crown. No shoes upon his feet, with clothes no more than rags. Still we manufacture security, storing treasures packed away in little bags. Sing it, yeah, sing it out. Sing it out from the bottom of your heart, from the bottom of your soul. Let it go, let it flow. Sing glory, glory, glory. Yeah. The light, it shines bright. Oh, it goes to show there's a different way. But we called him a fool, and now we go to great lengths to gain the world. But still mountains move, 'cause it came to peel away the paint and to save us from worshiping the golden plated calf. We better check what we have. His love is not expensive, it's way beyond a price. Still we're infatuated with the impressions we try to buy. Oh, when love steers us away from all that captures our eyes. So sing it, yeah, sing it out. Sing it out from the bottom of your heart, from the bottom of your soul. Let it go, let it flow. Sing glory, glory, glory. Yeah, 'cause the light, it shines bright. Oh, it glows. So oh, sing it, yeah, sing it. Sing it up from the bottom of your heart, from the bottom of your soul. Let it go, let it flow. Sing it up from the bottom of your heart, from the bottom of your soul. Let it go, let it flow. Sing it up from the bottom of your heart, from the bottom of your soul. Let it go, let it show. There are no jewels in his crown.
Man, great stuff right there. No jewels. You sent me a demo of that song. We played it on my podcast, Ragamuffin Archive Revisited, a couple weeks ago. And man, such a great song, man. And really looking forward to this album. The Kickstarter is happening now. Now, if, for anybody who's interested, there is a link in the description of the video that they're watching right now. Check out the Kickstarter campaign. There's some great rewards. You can, I mean, Mitch will come clean your house for you. Which I think is a first.
That's a first for me. I don't think I've ever cleaned anything in my life.
So he's not promising
actually, it'll be. For the record, I'm a very good cleaner.
Oh, okay. Okay. I would say if you weren't going to, we don't have to promise it'll be good. It'll just be cleaner than when he started. Also, I think, signed lyric or handwritten lyrics is the first time I think that you've ever included that in a Kickstarter campaign. That's very cool. Any song anybody wants, right?
Any song that I've written.
Okay, so I can't get like Inagata De Vita, American Pie.
That's right. Yeah.
So check out the link to the Kickstarter, back this project. You know, it's, I know it's going to be a great record. I can't wait for it. Now, right now, we are pleased to present, for the first time ever streaming anywhere, the Live in Morton video, which I think is hard for people to see this. This is a great cover, man. I love the cover of this thing.
Oh, that's cool. My friend Aaron did that, and we talked about what we wanted it to look like, and he did a wonderful job.
Yeah, it's great. Tell me about Mitch McVicker Live in Morton. Let's introduce this for everybody.
Yeah, that was a time when my friend Doug Craig Garber in Peoria, Illinois, or he lives in Morton, Illinois, wanted to film a concert for me, and a whole bunch of people came out for it. We got word out across the wherevers, and a whole bunch of people came out for it. And my friend Dave Sprinkle was playing with me at the time. And that doesn't happen very often. It hasn't happened for 6 or 7 years now. But it was a fun experience to do what I do and to share what I get to share. And to have people there that were excited to hear it. It was in a nice theater that doesn't happen for me all the time. So it was a great experience that, you know, I'm sharing songs that I don't play right now, because, you know, as just time moves on after, I think that was 7 or 8 years ago, I think.
And, so, when the album The Gray came out.
Yeah. Right after that. Yeah. And talking about things that I haven't talked about for a while. So it's good for me to go back and look at it and understand where I was and where I am and where I am going and how that's all kind of intertwined. So I'm grateful that you're showing it.
Well, everybody, Mitch McVicker, Live in Morton. Enjoy it. Mitch, thanks so much for being here.
Thank you, Joe.
Good evening. How's everybody doing tonight? My name is Chuck Tate. I'm the pastor of Rock Church in East Peoria. So we just want to say thank you for being here. I also want to take this time to personally thank Doug and Kate Garber for putting this whole thing together. Tonight, we get to all participate in a live DVD recording. So on behalf of the Garbers and Rock Church, can you put your hands together right now and let's welcome Mitch McVicker. Danger is everywhere.
footsteps, just waiting at the door. It's where I'm going, where I've been. That's the walk of faith, time and time again. So I am not afraid of who I'm a trying to get. Tell me you're closer than you have ever been, 'cause I can't feel that now. I just feel alone again. No matter how close I get, the fears keep crashing in. Show me your love is more than what's dangerous. Just let me know you're here, and I'll be brave, I swear. Been swirling on that danger spiral. I've seen the world from top, and then I slip, I fall. Every single day I find I'm spinning, spinning. It's nothing I can't take. Oh, who am I kidding? Tell me you're closer than you have ever been, 'cause I can't feel that now. I just feel alone again. No matter how close I get, the fears keep crashing in. Show me your love is more than what's dangerous. Just let me know you're here, and I'll be brave, I swear. Closer than you have ever been, 'cause I can't feel that now. I just feel alone again. No matter how close I get, the fears keep crashing in. Show me your love is more than what's dangerous. Tell me you're closer than you have ever been, 'cause I can't feel that now. I just feel alive. Let me know you're here, and I'll be brave, I swear, I swear, I swear. Danger is everywhere. So let me know you're here. Danger is everywhere. Let me know. 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 Dang.
Thank you.
It's real cool to see you all here. It's wonderful to get to do this. As always, each night is wonderful. But this is good. It's not the end of the world, it's not the end of the rope, it's not a dead end if I got nowhere else to go. My hope has not run out, the well has not run dry, because the river runs deep and wide. So I'm jumping in, though I can't swim, and you're keeping me afloat. I'm hanging on, trusting in trust, yeah, I'm still afloat. Oh, I'm still afloat, yeah, I'm still afloat. I'm all over the map, but mercy's all over me, and it will override when I cannot see. If my welcome's wearing out, and chances start wearing thin, I'll wear it on my sleeve, and I'll leap in. I won't sit on the side, I'll go ahead and dive, cause you're keeping me afloat. I'm leaping to believe in you. Oh yeah, I'm still afloat. Yeah, I'm still afloat. Yeah, I'm still afloat. Although the water's deep, well, it sparkles blue, and when it covers me, oh, you come to my rescue. It's not the wrong end, if I know I will be alright. Cause through the whole shebang, each hole will have an ace. And I'll be leaning on holy, holy, holy grace, and dreaming of that pool of love where you're keeping me afloat. I've tasted of that pool of love, because I'm still afloat. Yeah, I'm still afloat. Yeah, I'm still afloat. It's not the end of the world. It's not the end of the world now. I'm still afloat. It's not the end of the world now. I'm still afloat. I'm still afloat. Yeah, it's not the end of the world now. I'm still afloat, I'm still afloat, I'm still afloat, yeah, I'm still afloat. That song and the last song we did in this next song are from a new record that I just did. It's called The Gray, parentheses, When Black and White Fade. And I wanted to call it that because I think the love of God is beyond all calculation, you know. But, so,
so many times we try and approach life in these real black and white terms, try and calculate it all out and get it figured out until everything makes sense. But I think the love that Jesus was talking about is this vast, all-encompassing grayness. Not to say that anything goes, but rather to say that everything is included. So I'm just hoping to live more and more in that grayness with each day.
I went swimming in a stream that flowed straight uphill. Sat down on sun-drenched wooded ground. The bees are dancing round the flowers on the windowsill, and soon a sweetness will abound. So I'll remember the circle with every hurdle now. All things I can go walking through. All things are gonna be used. All things make me who I'll be. All things are the beginning and the ending, everything in between. All things. So Basel City, oh, there is still a peace. Yet in the silence the mind can swell. Out on the mountaintop peak, it's hard to breathe. But in the desert, the lake is filled. Because when nothing grows, there is still a hope that tells. I have all things I can go walking through. All things are gonna be used. All things make me who I'll be. All things are the beginning and the ending, everything in between. Round every corner I hold a board your life. With every turn I take, I recall I'm being made. Through every little phase, with every shift of mind, I'm okay, I'm alright, I'm gonna let it fly. Through all things. All things, I can go walking through. All things are gonna be used. All things make me who I'll be. All things are the beginning and the ending, everything in between. All things.
This next song is one that means a lot to me to get to do. It's a song that I got to write with Rich Mullins, and I traveled with Rich and did concerts, and then I was in the car wreck that killed Rich. We were roommates when we were traveling and when we weren't, and being in the same car wreck as Rich, I got pretty messed up to myself. And I miss him a lot. A whole lot of people miss him. But before that happened, we got to make this up.
Joseph took his wife and a child, and he went to Africa to escape the rage of a deadly king. And there along the banks of the Nile, Jesus listened to the song the captive children used to sing. My deliverer is coming, my deliverer is standing by. My deliverer is coming, my deliverer is standing by. Will never break his promise. He is written it upon the sky. My deliverer is coming. My deliverer is standing by. Yeah, he's standing by. Thirsty land, water from the canyon heights, poured itself out from Lake Sanger's broken heart. And there in the Sahara winds, Jesus heard the whole world cry for the healing flowing from his own scars. Oh, my deliverer is coming. My deliverer is standing by. My deliverer is coming. My deliverer is standing by. I will never die. this promise. Though I doubt my heart, though I doubt my eyes, my deliverer is coming. My deliverer is standing by. Okay, can you sing it out with me? My deliverer is coming. My deliverer is standing by. With the whole world, let it fly. My deliverer is coming. My deliverer is standing by. It's true, so let it rise. My deliverer is coming. My deliverer is standing by. Sing it, mean it, believe it. My deliverer is coming. My deliverer is standing by. Keep it flowing, take it over. My deliverer is coming. My deliverer is standing by. Yeah, sing it out again.
Being in that same car wreck is rich. I got pretty messed up too myself, like I said, and I had broken bones, collapsed lungs. I was in a coma in the hospital for a long time. And I know a lot of people know the story by now, but I do have to touch on it a bit each night, because it's a big part of how I've experienced the Lord's faithfulness. None of it made any sense, I know that. It made no sense to me why Rich had been taken. It made no sense to me why I was in the condition I was in the hospital. None of it made a bit of sense. But like I've said before, you know, it didn't make sense. But I don't know that God is terribly concerned with making sense. I think God is more concerned with the truth. The truth is that the faithfulness of Jesus persists through our stuff, through our hard, difficult, trying things. See, my road back was a difficult one. It was a hard one with a lot of bumps. But whose road doesn't have bumps? Whose road doesn't have bumps? To varying different degrees, we're all going through something. And if you're like me, it's easy to get focused in on the bumps and forget about being on the road. You see, you are on a road that's taking you somewhere. You're being led down a road by the one who's placed you upon the road and set the road out in front of you. So I guess even the bumps are kind of holy and sacred, not because they're anything in and of themselves, but because they're on the road. To varying different degrees, we're all going to go through bumps, around twists and turns, through fog where we can't even see what's going on. We're all going to go through stuff. But the faithfulness of Jesus persists. And you, you're being made. You're being worked upon, molded and constructed, turned into who the Lord would have you become. And often it seems like God uses that which we would never choose to go through on our own. So if you haven't gone through something rough, you will. If you have gone through something rough, still you will. But the faithfulness of the Lord persists. And through it all, as we travel down the road, we're being made. We're being worked upon, molded.
Still somehow I love you more with each new day. So I thought I'd write you. Yeah, I thought I'd send my new address. I've been staring at your picture that's sitting here on my desk, and I thought you might be wondering if I'm okay. I'm alive and I'm living in a place where the world's crust has shifted. And the stars and the Milky Way, they're giving a party for New Mexico. Yes, I've come to the desert just to find my way to forever, and you are so welcome here if you're ever in New Mexico. So I want to thank the one who leads us for the way that he has led, for the times we've spent together, and for the times we ain't seen yet. But still somehow, this is the path we must both walk alone. And we can't measure the distance, but we'll treasure every step. And I know his love will give us the strength we need to press on. Well, let's hold on to him. He will show us our way home. I'm alive and I'm living in a place where the world's crust has shifted. And the stars and the Milky Way, they're giving a party for New Mexico. And yes, I've come to the desert just to find my way to forever. You are so welcome here
if you're ever in New Mexico. And the stars can be so bright and the air so thin. As I'm looking out tonight, I think about you and you're looking for him. And I'm alive and I'm living in a place where the world's crust has shifted. And the stars in the Milky Way, they're giving a party for New Mexico. For New Mexico, yes, I've come to the desert just to find my way to forever. And you are so welcome here if you're ever in New Mexico. Yes, you are so welcome here if you're ever in New Mexico. New Mexico. Wherever you may go, go out looking for him. But in New Mexico,
well, you know, lots of times when I go to do a concert, I'll play in theaters, I'll play in churches or colleges and universities. But before I get there, a lot of times in our communication, they want to know, what is your statement of faith? I guess they just want to check me out and make sure that I'm okay, you know? And one of these last times, I answered it honestly, but at the same time, I like messing with people. So they asked me this, what is your statement of faith? I said, I don't have one. I don't have a statement of faith. My faith isn't anything to build a statement upon. I have a statement of grace. My faith was given to me. My faith is a gift. So I have no statement of faith. I have a statement of grace, and that is where I stand, upon that statement of grace. And so, if that's what you're looking for, if that meets your criteria, then goody goody. Shunt-ka-ka-ka-ka-ka-ka-ka-ka-ka-ka-ka-ka-ka-ka-ka-ka-ka-ka-ka-ka-ka-ka-ka-ka-ka-ka-ka-ka-ka-ka-ka-ka-ka-ka-ka-ka-ka-ka-ka-ka-ka-ka-ka-ka-ka-ka-ka-ka-ka-ka-ka-ka-ka-ka-ka-ka-ka-ka-ka-ka-ka-ka-ka-ka-ka-ka-ka-ka-ka-ka-ka-ka-ka-ka-ka-ka-ka-ka-ka-ka-ka-ka-ka-ka-ka-ka-ka-ka-ka-ka-ka-ka-ka-ka-ka-ka-ka-ka-ka-ka-ka-ka-ka-ka-ka-ka-ka-ka-ka-ka-ka-ka-ka-ka-ka-ka-ka-ka-ka-ka-ka-ka-ka-ka-ka-ka- I couldn't have done that if I wanted to.
Time turns, days run out, but no dirt can keep me down. 'Cause there are gates of love to open up and take me in. And there's a hope forevermore, and my bones will dance for joy. Or you may say my lungs will not fill up ever again. I don't care what becomes of the me you see. You can lay me there, but I'll rise up. No, you can't bury me. So now death, where is your sting? Nothing compares with the glory that's found past affliction, where the cloud of witnesses sing. And to the right and to the left, I come to life, and with each breath of grace from the giver that saves and delivers me. I don't care what becomes of the me you see. You can lay me there, but I'll rise up. No, you can't bury me. Beyond the grave, it's all gone, there's no more pain. Beyond the grave, it's all gone, there's no more pain. Beyond the grave, it's all gone, there's no more pain. Or tears, pain, or fears, pain, it tears a pain, it fears a pain, it tears, and I don't care what becomes of the me you see. You can lay me there, but I'll rise up. No, you can't bury me. No, 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 I don't care what becomes of the me you see. The me you see, go and lay me there. Up. No, you can't bury me. You can't bury me.
This is Dave Sprinkle. He plays a mean chain. He's okay on bass, percussion, and keyboard too. I'm grateful to get to play with Dave every now and again. I travel and do this by myself a lot of times, but every now and again, Dave will come out and join me for a few concerts, and this is one of them. And he's a wonderful musician, as you can see and hear. He's a he's a missionary, and he's also a really good driver. I said no.
Jim came walking down the road singing songs and humming on hymn tunes. Though he'd never set foot in a church on Sunday morning, the smile on his face again out of place and flicks of his shirt and shoes. It made me wonder what it was that kept him going. Spent most of his young days working downtown in a sawmill. And so a childhood is something he never known. All the extra time he had on his mind, every now and then his heart would spill. And he'd start singing all the way home. And he'd sing, I don't know much. I know my love, and one day I'll be sitting up in heaven on an easy chair, sipping lemonade. Love lives there. Round about that time, the bells chimed and the church doors flew open, and a whole herd of saints came running along Jim's way, talking about salvation, hope and love, and everything else they didn't know about. And when they saw Jim, all of that changed. Now it takes a special kind of man to avoid a confrontation. And if away Jimmy looked, he had nowhere to go. They started throwing out names, throwing punches and throwing laughter. And when they were through, blood was dripping from his nose. But he sang, I've heard about blood. I think it stands for love. And one day I'll be sitting up in heaven on an easy chair, sipping lemonade. Love lives there. Jim knew what he had inside of him. He wouldn't hear nothing different. The moral to the story is he just keeps on keeping on. He ain't whitewashed. You won't find him on the corner breaking. He just knows his love and he knows his song. And he sings, I got all I want because I got my love. I got all I want because I got my love. Whoa, I got all I want. I got all I want. Can you join me in singing that? I got all I want. Yeah, yeah. Yes, you can now. I got all. Let it go loud. From your heart. Sing it hard. Okay, now try this one. Try this. I got all I want. Yeah, sing this one, sing. I got all I want, yeah.
I got all I want.
Sing it again.
I got all I want.
Sing it again.
I got all I want.
Okay, now ladies.
I got all I want.
Sing it, ladies.
I got all I want.
Sing it, ladies.
I got all I want.
Okay, now guys.
I got all I want.
Sing it out, guys. Sing it, guys. Okay, now everyone together. Yeah. Okay, now let's all sing.
I got all I want. Sing it out again. Sing it again.
Okay, here we go, ladies.
Sing it, ladies, sing it, ladies. Sing it, ladies, sing it, ladies.
Yes, yes. Now that was guttural, guttural.
Yeah, how about everyone, let's sing. Here we go, guys. Sing it, guys, sing it, guys. Sing it out, sing it, guys.
Yes, yes, now that. You know, that was embarrassingly good. Try this one now, try. I got all I want now. Okay, try this, try. Woo! 3, 4. Nailed it. And one day I was sitting up in heaven on an easy chair, sipping lemonade, love is there. One day I was sitting up in heaven on an easy chair, sipping lemonade, love lives there. One day I was sitting up in heaven on an easy chair, sipping lemonade, yeah, sitting up in heaven on an easy chair, sipping lemonade. Aha, sitting up in heaven on an easy chair, I'm sipping lemonade. Love is there.
Traveling like I do has its rough stuff. It has its own, I don't know, sacrifices, you know, going from point A to point B to point C to G to M, back to L, back to B. You know, it seems very happenstance, but you know, that's just the way it is with my doing it. Like I have to do it. I get to drive past a lot of great stuff, a lot of really great stuff, and it'd be fascinating to stop and check it out and look at it. But if I ever do write a book about all this, I think it would be titled Cool Stuff That I've Driven Past. Because stopping is just, it's not an option. And I travel this way because it's the way that has worked out the best for me. You know, I'm able to do music and minister to people and point people to Jesus and hopefully give them something good and artful. And I still get to be with my family on a pretty regular basis. It's not perfect, but it's what I know. And it's kind of my lot. You know, this is how God has led me to do it.
You're a good singer, people. You're good clapper, people. You're good I Got All I Wanters. There's a lot of talent in this room. And I was here to see it.
Thank you.
now we're just gonna let that marinate. This is my little ukulele. I think somebody just went, aw. You have such a tender heart for instruments. It goes by uke. Or is my, it's my philosophy with everything. Goes by uke, or as my daughter likes to call it, my daughter's name is Brooklyn, and Brooklyn is now 9 years old. But I remember when she was toddling around, and I had all my stuff spread out in the garage, and I was out there practicing. She would always love to come out. She would go straight for this. She would pick this up, and she would call this her guitar. And it is a great blast. It is a great blessing to get to go here and there doing this. I've gotten to go, to 49 states and 13 countries. I've gotten to go to a lot of really great places and meet a lot of wonderful people and get reacquainted with great people. I've gotten to go to some fun and exotic places, like Morton. I get to be home often, but often I'm gone. So you just have to stay in the best communication that you can. So I was talking to Brooklyn from wherever I happened to be, and she asked me. She said, "When are you coming home to my house?" I said, "You know what? I will be there real soon, and I can't wait. I cannot wait. We are going to go run through the trees. We're going to feed the ducks. We're going to catch the ice cream man. But right now I'm gone, and I'm doing some concerts." She said, "Oh, you're doing concerts. You're doing concerts." And then she asked me. She said, "Are you playing my guitar?" I said, "Yep. Not as good as you, but thank you for letting me borrow it, and I will get it right back to you." And now, she always likes to make sure, whenever I talk to her, she always likes to make sure that I'm always, always telling that story.
Towards the morning, and if I drive too fast, me over. If I fly, I wanna lay in a field of rest. Yeah, draw me closer. Draw me closer to you. I'm walking through the park. I'm further from the dark. Yeah, yeah. I'm walking through the park. So now capture me. Capture my heart, I said capture me. Capture my heart, oh yes, capture me. Capture my heart, capture my heart, capture my heart. If I drive too fast, oh, pull me over. If I fly, I wanna land in a field of rest. Yeah, draw me closer to you, Lord. Come closer to you. Come closer to you.
My little girl. I also have a little boy. His name is Payson. And Payson is 4 years old, and he's a little ball of everything. I'm grateful to get to be a part of his life. I've learned so much from him. He is a wonderful teacher, and he is a blessed little hellion. I remember when Payson was little, and we would lay him down to go to sleep in his crib/bed, and he had up over top of him, he had one of those things that goes round and round, you know, and he would just lay there and he would go numb. He would get lulled to sleep. And then I got to thinking that we got a lot of that stuff too. You know, we got a lot of that stuff. A lot of times as we walk through this world, we find ourselves ensnared by and entranced with various surfacey things, you know? And we just find ourselves and we grow numb. We get lulled to sleep. We forget who we are. Don't forget who you are. It's easy to. It's easy to as we walk through this world. But it's not that hard to remember Who are you? You are the one in whom the Lord has invested greatly. You are Jesus' kid, the one in whom the Lord is greatly invested in. For therein lies our identity. Therein lies our significance. Established, solidified. Yet, if you're like me, sometimes, often, it goes in one ear and out the other. And you're like, gosh, it's got to come down to what I do. It must come down to what I do. It's got to come down to what I do. I remember when Payson was little, and he wanted, you know, he had just started to walk everywhere. He just started to walk, and he wanted to experience everything, walking every place he could. We live just to the north of Atlanta, Georgia, and right on the edge of the Appalachian Mountains. So our backyard is one big giant hill, and in the south, where you don't want to mow, you put down pine straw as mulch, you know. So that hill is covered with pine straw. And Payson got all interested. He wanted to walk up it. He'd never walked up the hill before. He wanted to walk up the hill. And I thought, this is not a good idea. You are going to slip and slide all over that slickery pine straw. You're going to lose your balance, stumble, fall. I just don't think it's happening. But he said, and he convinced me. So I thought, you know what, we will go up together. We'll go up together. We'll hold hands and we'll go up the hill together. So we start up, and here goes Payson. And I am the one slipping and sliding, falling all over the place, can't keep my balance. And I thought, what is going on here? I am the much better walker. But Payson, I finally figured it out. It was his low center of gravity. You know, it was his low center of gravity, who he was. It was his low center of gravity. It was who he was. It was who he was that enabled him to get up the hill. He wasn't trusting in any kind of abilities he had or skills or any calculations to put the right step here and thereafter. It was who he was that got him up the hill. Who of us doesn't have a hill? It's being who you are that enables you to get up the hill. It's remembering who you are that gets you up the hill. It's not your skills or your abilities or your calculations. It's being who you are. It's not your determination, your diligence, your discipline. It's remembering who you are. The one in whom the Lord has invested greatly, Jesus' kid, established, solidified. It's got to come down to what I do. Must come down to what I do. And we get obsessed with piles, hoping that our pile of good stuff that we've done is bigger than our pile of bad stuff that we've done. And we've all been there adding on to each one of them. But they are just piles. They are just piles. Jesus does not give a rat's ankle about your piles. Doesn't matter how high your good one gets. Doesn't matter how high your bad one gets. It will not alter the Lord's investment in you. It will not alter the Lord's investment in you. For it's not based upon our steps, what we do or what we have done. It's based upon what the Lord has done and continues to do in us each day. Established, solidified. Jesus' kid, your identity and significance. Yet. So this has ended up being a little song for Payson. It's a lullaby. It's a lullaby slash protest song. What's marketable? If you listen to the world, then your soul gets filled and your heart gets told. Only what is sold has any kind of value. So what it all comes down to, plastic horses, they're spinning circles, and it's keeping everyone so happy, happy now. Plastic horses, they're spinning circles, but it's a merry-go-round, a merry-go-round. Yeah, it's a merry-go-round, yeah, 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 yeah. The growing stain of the material, it's a cellophane of the imperial. It measures all of us by what we got. But I shall not want, oh no, I shall not, plastic horses. They're spinning circles, and it's keeping everyone so happy, happy now. Plastic horses, they're spinning circles, but it's a merry-go-round, a merry-go-round. Yeah, it's a merry-go-round, yeah, yeah. Come on, have a little fun. Oh, get numb. Plastic horses, they're spinning circles, and it's keeping everyone so happy now. Plastic horses, they're spinning circles, and it's keeping everyone so happy, happy, happy now. Plastic horses, they're spinning circles, and it's keeping everyone so happy, happy now. Plastic horses, they're spinning circles, but it's a merry-go-round, a merry-go-round. Yeah, it's a merry-go-round. Singing that, right, yeah, 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 it's your part, right, yeah, yeah. Lift it high, sing, right, yeah, up through the sky, bring it, so remember that, we'll come back around to it. Thank you. I want to thank Doug Garber for doing this. And it's good to be back here in this little corner of the world. So John, did you come? Yes? Yeah, there you are. I remember after the wreck happened, I was in the hospital just over in Peoria. And John was my nurse. He saw me in a pretty bad condition. There was a lot of people in this community that helped out significantly. But I remember one night when I was in the hospital, and John had through the night shift, as best as I can remember. I don't have much of a memory of anything at that time. But I do remember this one occasion when, you know, I was in bad shape, and I was supposed to, when I needed to take a whiz, or what's the PC term? Somebody let me know. When I needed to do that, I was supposed to push this red button, and John would come and he would help me out and help me walk to the restroom and get there, and, you know, help me balance and put one foot in front of the other. But this was about, you know, I'm guessing it was 2-3 a.m. and I thought, man, I really have to go. But I don't want to bother John. He's probably got stuff going on. So I decided not to push the red button. And I just kind of rolled over onto my side and and I thought it was, you know, I thought it was a good move. And then John came in, you know, with my breakfast about, you know, a couple hours later. And he was like, "Hey, what good morning, what's going on? What's up with the puddle on my floor?" I was like, "Well, what are you talking about?" He said, "But you should have just pushed the red button." And I was like, "Man, what?" He said, "Well, this puddle on the floor. You see this puddle on the floor, right?" I said, "Oh, wasn't me." Right, John?
Side of my life's road, but the cottonwood seeds are all blowing around, just like my feelings, like my dreams gone cold and tossed about. But I'm reminded that it all lands in, I can lie down. You wrap me up in strong, strong arms, and you hold my soul right next to your heartbeat. And the only sounds of your sweet, sweet love. And I could stay right here and never move, just being held by you. Yeah, being held. Lost in the forest, that's a chorus in my head. I cannot find a single sign pointing out. I just hear the voices of choices made closing in. But you're still here, like the cool crisp air that has me surrounded. You wrap me up in strong, strong arms, and you hold my soul right next to your heartbeat. And the only sounds of your sweet, sweet love. And I could stay right here and never move, just being held by you. So pull me close, never let me go. Keep me near forever.
wrap me up in strong, strong arms. You hold my soul right next to your heartbeat. And the only sounds of your sweet, sweet love. And I could stay right here and never, ever move. Just being held by you. Yeah, being held.
What's really cool and fascinating is, you know, we as humans are imperfect. God is perfect. So he always seems to be one step ahead of us. He's molding us into who we are. And each one of us plays a big part in each other's lives. We serve a purpose unto each other. No matter how long the duration that we are in contact with one another, that time we spend together will affect our day, which can change our entire week, our month, and then even the years following. And often we take it for granted, since it happens so frequently, and we don't even let it sink in. We don't even soak it all in at all. And we don't notice it or even realize it until it's too late, after that person is gone. But it's real cool how God has orchestrated us to be a part of each other.
It is really one of the chicken's best performances.
leather seats. At least I got an engine. I don't got an earring. Yeah, but I got an ear to hear with. I don't hang with the right people. I'm just lucky that I got good friends. If I don't wear the latest fashions, well, at least I'm wearing something. I will never be hip, never be cool, and be the talk of the town. Seems like I got things backwards and everything turned around, yeah. But I'm living in a world that's upside down, and blessed are the poor in spirit. Living in a world that's inside out, blessed are the pure in heart. Inside out and upside down, yeah, but I just might see God. Just might see my God. I don't get the right haircut, but at least I got nice hats. I don't eat in the popular restaurants, but at least I get my daily bread. I don't drive the fastest sports car, I'm just lucky that I get around. And my house ain't much to look at, oh, but I got somewhere to lie down. I will never be in, never be praised, never be a genius. I know this all sounds crazy, but somehow it makes sense to me. I'm living in a world that's upside down, and blessed are the poor in spirit. Living in a world that's inside out, blessed are the pure in heart. Inside out and upside down, yeah, but I just might see God. I don't know the right people, but I know who can save me. I don't know the right people, no, 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 but my Savior, He knows me, He knows me. Yeah, yeah, I'm living in a world that's upside down. Oh, yeah. And I'm living in a world that's inside out. Blessed are the poor in spirit and the pure in heart. And someday I'll see God, yeah. I'm living in a world that's upside down. And blessed are the poor in spirit. I'm living in a world that's inside out. Blessed are the pure in heart are blessed. Inside out, out, upside down, but someday you're gonna see someday, yeah. I'm gonna see, yeah. Someday we'll see, someday, yeah, you will see God.
See God.
Yeah, you're gonna see God.
Yeah.
play harmonica because you really don't have to be much of a musician to do so. You know, you just get the right key of harmonica for whatever song. You know, if the song's in the key of E, you get the E harmonica. If it's in the G, you get the G harmonica. But just do not, you just gotta remember. You just gotta remember to get the right one. Or if you don't, it sounds like, what's the PC term?
They just got it.
Somebody let me know.
Some curves coming my way. The road is getting slippery. This journey's long. This night's been dark. Can't recall where I've gone, but it's been hard. And now I don't want it easy. I just don't want to follow my own lead no more. So take the wheel. Take me wherever you want. Just lead me home. Yeah, take the wheel. Whatever you want now, I am ready to go. Just be my guide, my fuel, my lights, my steel, my shine, my wheels, my rubber to the road, my off, my on, my here, my gone, my song playing on the radio. My map, my mission, my cylinders hitting, my air condition, my caffeine buzz, my peace, my strength that is on going on my way, be my patient love. I try to pick the best way but this. Sticking my feet one way and my soul wants to go to another place. I'm in trouble hearing your voice. In trouble steering my course. Yeah, yeah, yeah. So take the wheel. Take me wherever you want. Just lead me home. Now take the wheel. Whatever you want now. I am ready to go. Yeah, take the wheel wherever you want now. I am ready to go. My lights, my steel, be my shine, my wheels, now be my rubber to the road, and be my off and my on, be my here and my gone, be my patient love. All right. Okay, now what we have is a participatory situation. So when I point to you, you're gonna go, what? And then you're gonna go, that's what. Okay, so here comes what. There we go. Here comes that's what. Yes. Here comes what. Yeah. Here comes that's what. Yeah. Here comes what. Got your light, still shine, wheels jumping through the roof. Jump.
the radio, radio, my map, my mission, my cylinders, hitting my air condition, my caffeine buzz, my face, my strength, and as I'm going, I'm away from love is patient, patient, my love is kind, my patient, the patient, the beat, my patient love, yeah.
Is there anything up here I haven't played yet? Gosh, you must have been taking notes. Everything will be played. This actually isn't, it's not quite my last song. Hear yourselves in the loop. You clap right there at the end, and it sounds awesome. You're good, you. this.
All is a sticky subject. It's like a dangerous tightrope that I cross. I need a net to catch me when I lose my balance. I've counted on my stance way too much. I failed to see your hands opened up, reaching out more than I ever thought. You'll stop at nothing just to hang with the drunkards and all those who steal. Hang with the adulterers and all of hell's clientele. Hang with the prostitutes and meet with the thieves. Hang with the liars, in other words, me. There is both rain and sunshine. When the sea comes, the wind still knocks me down. When my soul grows quiet, still the tiniest cloud is like a fog that settles down on the bootstrap notions I've pulled up. Each weather front listens to you. You'll stop at nothing. And just to hang with the drunkards and all those who steal. Hang with the adulterers and all of hell's clientele. Hang with the junkies and meet with the thieves. Hang with the liars, in other words, me. Dangerous tightrope, but you hold my hand. You hang with the drunkards and all those who steal. Hang with the adulterers and all of hell's clientele. Hang with the prostitutes and meet with the thieves. Hang with the liars, in other words, me. You hang with the drunkards and all those who kill. Hang with the adulterers and all of hell's clientele. Hang with the junkies and meet with the thieves. Hang with the liars, in other words, me.
I get to go lots of places doing this. I get to take a lot of long drives. And that's a lot of time to have experiences, have some weird experiences. I remember one time I was on a long drive. I was on a long drive and I pulled over to get something to eat. And I got done eating. I came back out to hop into the van and drive on. And as I was getting in the van, I noticed that the windshield was covered with ladybugs. I guess it was ladybug time. And I thought, you know, I thought, well, this is cute. But as I drove along the side roads to get back out there onto the interstate, you know, one by one, and then I get going full blast down the interstate, and there's three of them hanging on, and I had no idea how they were able to pull this off. I found myself rooting them on. I was getting pretty attached to them. And I thought, you know what? It's time. It is time to name them. So we had Reginald, Samantha, and Osgood. Reginald was the first to go. 10 miles down the road. And it hurt a little bit. But Samantha and Osgood were holding strong. And I had no idea how this was possible. I don't understand all the aerodynamicity stuff. But I thought maybe, just maybe, Their dome-shaped shells had something to do with, you know, deflecting and diffracting the oncoming wind and allowed them to stay there on the slickery windshield. 20 miles down the road, Samantha. You stay gold, Samantha. But Osgood. And people ask me, they say, well, how did you know? How did you know what to name them? You know, male, female. I'm like, well, you know, they were right there on the windshield. We'd now traveled 45 miles. We had crossed over a state line. We were a long ways from Osgood's home. And now I know what Osgood did. When he finally came to, I know what he did. He buzzed over to the other side of the interstate. He was hanging out at a rest area over there, scouting out the right windshield to hop on. Get a ride back home. Has anything like that ever happened to you? You know, has your grip ever gotten slippery? Have you ever gotten blown off course? And when you finally come to, you realize that you're a long ways from home. we got a way home. We got arms to catch us and not let us get squished. And do not forget about your shell. The very spirit of the Lord to diffract and deflect that which is oncoming and may become too great for us, and in fact enables the journey at all. Remember, you have a way home. I was grateful to be reminded by Reginald, Samantha, and Osgood. So you keep your eyes peeled for those crazy little critters. I recently started playing the introduction to this song, and there was somebody sitting out in one of the front rows that was familiar with the newest album that it's on. And they said, "Could you please tell us what this song is about?" It's just my attempt at writing a little parable, a little metaphor about dealing with the world. And it probably just ended up being a stupid little song.
Her tongue was twisting with every conversation. My mind's now riddled by the institution. And there is a context I don't understand. There is an interest the night has stolen away. So now bring back the day. And she is down by the seashore, where Peter Viper picks apart the brain. And she sells Missy shells full of pain. My soul is crumbling. Lying face down in life's terrain. My heart's grown numb and every beat now wastes away. There is a sentence that's been given out to me. Punctuation that I can't see. Through tears, now here come the years. And she is down by the seashore, where Peter Piper picks apart the brain. And she sells me. me see shells full of pain. In everybody's life, there's a Jezebel. Sometimes it's simply the whole wide world. Now and then we all buy some seashells that can't be returned. And she is down by the seashore where Peter Piper picks apart the brain. And she sells Missy shells full of pain. She sells me seashells. She sells me seashells full of pain. And I'm wasting away. Some wasting away. Don't let me waste away. Don't let me.
I think this is the last one. Yes? Horn. Inspired by a trip I took to Ireland a few years ago to do some concerts over there. And I loved getting to hang out with the musicians and listen to what they were doing, watch what they were doing. then when I got home, I thought, you know what? I had these words going through my head. I wanted to turn into a song, a little prayer song, and I thought, well, maybe I'll turn it into one of those Irish songs and do something that they were doing with it. And I don't know if I pulled it off, but they're not here. So it's a party prayer. It's a prayer party, party, party prayer, prayer party.
Snuff the flame. You've been promised a stone with a new name. Within you there's a glowing treasure, like flowers of pastures green. Darkest shadows can't cover up its gleam. So come back to your heart, come back to your soul, come back to your heart, come back home. Yet, look who runs our way. Blessed are those who return and long for grace. And there's no dead end, the life we live, it showers from on high. And it swells within you, remember what's inside. Come back to your heart, come back to your soul, come back to your heart, come back home, come back to your heart, come back to your soul, come back to your heart.
it is a blessed, gracious light bulb that goes off for us. Because a lot of times we go, gosh, isn't Jesus cool? He saves me and he saves the scoundrels. Isn't Jesus amazing? He saves me and he saves the ruffians too. It's a gracious, gracious light bulb that goes off for us when we go, wait a minute. Wait a second. I'm a scoundrel. I'm a ruffian. We've gotten really good at putting our best foot forward and letting that be what people see. But Jesus sees the heart. Jesus sees the inside us. And according to the scriptures, these people will not inherit the kingdom of heaven. According to the scriptures, it's these people that will not inherit the kingdom of heaven. Murderers. Adulterers. Drunkards. Thieves. Liars, those who've ever been mad, those who've ever been jealous. Does that leave anybody out? Basically, according to the scriptures, we are all screwed. According to the scriptures, we are all screwed. Yet, miraculously, because it is not based upon our steps, it is not based upon what we do, what we have done, rather, it is based upon what Jesus has done and continues to do. Somehow we are in. Though when you do the math and add it all up, it does not make sense, but we are in. So it's time. To stop judging. And I know we've all heard that before. It's time to stop judging people who sin. I know we've all heard that before. It's time to stop judging people who sin differently than we do. Because as I've gone here and there, I've come to one conclusion as I've talked with people from all different kinds of backgrounds, all different shapes, sizes, colors, different stories. One conclusion, we are all the same. We are all the same. We're all going through struggles. We're all going through difficulties. We're all hurting. Varying different degrees for each one of us. But we are all in this together. Clinging. Hanging on. Responding to the grace that has been so lavished upon us, hanging on, rather being held. Remember, never forget, never forget. You are being held as messed up as we are, because no, our steps don't lead us anywhere. But if we remember who we are if we be who we are, end with this one. Thank you so much for paying attention to us for a second. I don't need no woman to kiss me, and I don't need no man to stand by my side. And I don't need to slake my thirst with too much whiskey. Need to shuffle cards to pass the time. Cause the stars are bright and silvery, and with the dry ache of a lone coyote's whine, my Savior's calling, and I'm listening. Yes, I'm listening. Time to saddle up my pony and ride. Cause heaven is waiting just past the horizon, just over the mesas, across the great divide. Faith is blazing, this trail that I ride on. Up this mountain I'm praying, I have the strength to climb. I ain't looking for no seven golden cities. Oh, but I know there is a fortune somewhere to find. And there is a peace I hear whispering through the pinyons, and a love taller than the ponderosa pine. Heaven is waiting just past the horizon, just over the mesas, across the great divide. Yeah, oh, and faith.
is blazing. This trail that I ride on, up this mountain I'm praying, I have the strength to climb. Don't ask for no lengthy explanations when there's no reason quite wild enough. No words can be that tender. It's greater than the fears. It's greater than the fears we imagine. It's more than the warmth. It's more than the warmth we remember. It's always just beyond the pass. Let's go. Heaven is waiting just past the horizon, just over the mesas, across the great divide. That's right. And faith is blazing. This trail that I ride on, up this mountain I'm praying, I have the strength to climb. Heaven is waiting. Yeah. Heaven is waiting. 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 Open up your mind, 'cause heaven is waiting.
I guess somebody along the way noticed that I had some kind of a gift to do what I do. My parents bought me a guitar, I think when I was around 10, and then I took guitar lessons when I was 10, 11, and 12, something like that. And since then, I've just been trying to walk through the doors that are open to me. I mean, I've lived my life trying to be faithful to what the Lord is doing in me. Probably my greatest gift, if you pin me down, would be perseverance, for the better or for the worse. You know, everybody's greatest gift is also their greatest weakness, it seems. Their greatest strength is their greatest weakness. My perseverance, for better or for worse, I just will not stop. And so I'm grateful that God uses that for my betterment, uses that for my good, that my not stopping is generally for the good. But you know, that's also the greatest struggle that a lot of us have, is when we run into that wall, what is the call? To keep banging up against it or to stop? You know, so, and discernment has never been one of my greatest attributes, so I guess that's where the perseverance comes in, because I'll just keep banging up against it.
The sun floats to the top and the clouds open up, before dawn's dew burns off. Hallelujah. Before the ocean brings its tide low, and the gentle breeze of night blows, before the constellation sky glows. Hallelujah. Turn your face to morning's blaze. May your day be graced by love. Lift your eyes into the night. Sing with evening's blue dusk. Hallelujah. And trains leave, and the cellular wave stream, before the radio man speaks. Hallelujah. Before the neon starts buzzing, and the nightclubs fill up, yeah. If you're alone again by yourself, hallelujah. Turn your face to morning's blaze. May your day be graced by love, lift your eyes into the night. Sing with evening's blue dusk. Don't let your heart forget to pump. Don't let your scars cover your love. No, it's down there, it's inside you, inside you. Turn your face to morning's blaze. May your day be graced by love. Lift your eyes into the night. Sing with evening's blue dusk. May your day be graced by love. Sing with the evening's blue dusk. Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
People ask me how I became a Christian, and that is a hard one for me to answer. I grew up going to church. There were various instances in my life when I tried to take my faith to another level, and a lot of times that was instigated by something hard, difficult, bad.
And it sure seemed like each one of those times, God made me new. So I don't know exactly how and when it all went down. I'm just glad that it has. And I don't even know that it's much of my business, because I don't make myself a Christian. Jesus makes me one. And so I'm just trying to cling to that.
This is my prayer for renewal. I grew up in Kansas and loved it in the springtime when they would burn the grassland ranges, when they would burn the fields, you know, so that new green grass would grow. They would burn off of the brown, dried up, dead grass. It was amazing to watch a vacant, charred field suddenly give way to these green blades of grass. God does for us what God does for those fields. Hurts to be burned, but the good news is that we're being remade and redone into what God would have us become. Yeah, they're burning the fields in Kansas. The flint hills are all ablaze. It's a beautiful sight to watch the flames arise and watch the smoke drift away. And my memories run thick like that smoke, and the love that's here when I come back. I'm thankful for what I had, I'm thankful for what I have now. So like the fields, I wanna come to life again. Yeah, renew my soul, like that green grass on the prairies. Rekindle my heart with the passion for you. Restore my mind, oh, take my anxious thoughts away. And Lord, make me new, like only you can do. It's that time of year once again, when new life begins to stir. The light of the world is loose on the grasslands. So Lord, make me the salt of the earth, and renew my soul like that green grass on the prairies, and rekindle my heart with the passion for you, and restore my mind. Oh, take my anxious thoughts away, and Lord, make me new. I love it when I get to do this song. Because I speak of this, and I mention Kansas, and they're like, but everyone can resonate with the desire to be made new, with the hope that they're being redone and remade. As we're burned. So renew my soul, like that green grass on the prairies. Rekindle my heart with a passion for you. Restore my mind, take my anxious
his thoughts away. And Lord, make me new. Make me new. Make me new. Look, only you can do. Thank you so much. We will have to do this again. And kumbaya.
Singing songs and humming on hymn tunes. Though we never set foot in a church on Sunday morning, the smile on his face looked out of place from the looks of his shirt and shoes. Made me wonder what it was that kept him going. Spent most of his lonely days working downtown in the sawmill. And a childhood is something he'd never known. All the extra time he had on his mind, every now and then his heart would spill. And he starts singing all the way home. And he'd sing, I don't know much, but I know I love. And one day I'll be sitting up in heaven on an easy chair, sipping lemonade, love lives there. Around about the time the bells chimed and the church doors flew open, and a whole herd of saints came running along Jim's way, talking about salvation, hope, and love, and everything else they did not know about. And when they saw Jim, all of that changed. Now it takes a special kind of man to avoid a confrontation. And everywhere Jimmy looked, he had nowhere to go. They started throwing out names, throwing punches, and throwing laughter. And when they were through, buddies dripping from his nose. But he sang, I heard about blood. I think it stands for love. And one day I'll be sitting up in heaven on an easy chair, sipping lemonade, love lives there. Now Jim knew he had inside of him, and he would not hear anything different. The moral to the story is he just keeps on keeping on. Now he ain't whitewashed, you won't find him on the corner praying. He just knows his love and knows his song, and he sings, I've got all I want, 'cause I've got my love. Yeah, and one day I'll be sitting up in heaven on an easy chair, sipping lemonade, love lives there. Yeah, one day I'll be sitting up in heaven on an easy chair, sipping lemonade, love lives there. Yeah, one day I'll be sitting up in heaven on an easy chair, sipping lemonade, love lives there.
Well, what a great concert film right there. Mitch McVicker live in Morton. And our sincere thank you to Mitch for allowing us to make that concert available here on Ragamuffin Archive. That is, as far as I know, I believe that's the first time it's been available on streaming anywhere. And so we are truly honored to host it here on this channel. And it was a lot of fun just having Mitch on to talk about it and to talk about that new Kickstarter campaign that he recently launched. It's going on right now. And once again, if you haven't done so already, head on over to Kickstarter. There's a link in the description of this video, or you can go onto the Kickstarter website or the app and just search for Mitch McVicker, and his current campaign will come up. And I really encourage you to check out that page and the video. We're actually going to show you the video in a few minutes. But I really encourage you to check that out and to consider backing that campaign to help Mitch make a new album. Well, that's just about going to do it for our second ever Ragamuffin Movie Night. Just so much fun. And thank you to everybody who joined in and hung out with us tonight, and who hung out in the YouTube chat room, and just so much fun. And I'm so happy to just have you guys here with us tonight, and to be able to bring you great content like Mitch McVicker live in Morton. And I do want to encourage you to check out some of the other content that we've put out recently. I do a podcast on this channel every Sunday night, called Ragamuffin Archive Revisited. We've done a couple specials recently. Last month, we did a 30th anniversary tribute to the Liturgy Legacy and a Ragamuffin Band album. It's 30 years old last month. Last week was the 10th anniversary of Rick Elias's Job album. And so we did a special called Alternate Job. And really encourage you to check out those shows. This Sunday night, we've got a special guest going to be joining me, Hal Swift. Hal has a new album out called Growing Young, Songs Inspired by Rich Mullins. And he's going to be my guest this Sunday evening at 9 p.m. Eastern. And we're going to talk to Hal about this new record, play some music from the album, and also going to talk to him. We're going to find out some of the Rich Mullins songs that have really inspired Hal Swift over the years. It's going to be a lot of fun. So I encourage you to join us 9 p.m. Eastern this Sunday night. Also, just wanted to mention that I did another movie night. This is our second one. I did one last month with my friend John Adkins joined us for an interview afterward. But we showed two concert films that John made, A Few Good Men and The Concert, as best I remember it, two fantastic Rich Mullins concert films. That movie night is still available. If you missed it, check it out. We're going to have links for all this stuff in the description of this episode. And then finally, you know, unrelated, I do another podcast with my friend Chris Marchand. It's called Nostalgic Future Podcast. And it's a pop culture thing that we do. And we put out a new episode recently talking all about the new Beatles song, Now and Then. And it was a really fun time. Chris and I are both huge Beatles fans. And if that's your sort of thing, just check it out. Let us know what you think. All right. Well, thank you guys so much again for joining us for our second movie night here. We hope to do this again real soon. I'm going to leave you with the video from Mitch McVicker's Kickstarter campaign. Please watch this video and really consider supporting Mitch and this project. And just thank you guys and have a great night.
Hey, this is Mitch McVicker. I was in the car wreck that killed Rich Mullins a number of years ago. And after a long recovery, I've continued to live, love, and do music. And it's time to record another album. I want to release the album on April 5th, 2024, and I need you to help make it happen. I traveled with Rich and did concerts. We wrote songs. We were roommates. Rich was the greatest writer, musician, communicator, and original thinker that the world has ever known. And he pushed me to become a musical artist. So in many ways, this album is my response to Rich's investing himself in me. I wanted to honor Rich as I do what he was pushing me to do. So yeah, it's time to record again. But why? Why am I making another album? That can seem like a bit of a mystery on the surface. It really doesn't make a lot of sense to do another record. Financially, about any other job would benefit me just as much. A different job would likely not take me away from my kids for stretches of time. But this is my vocation. This is who I am. This is what I do.
If you're feeling that the sun is gone, your morning will come. If you're feeling that the sun is gone, walk on. If the night will never end, my friend, you're led to transcend. If the night will never end, my friend, amen and amen. This life's remedy is simple.
I suffered a closed head injury from the wreck that I was in with Rich. That put me in a coma. I was in the hospital for a long time. I had collapsed lungs. I was afflicted with double vision and the loss of my singing voice. And it was a mystery as to what would become of me. But here I am now, having done nearly 2,500 concerts and 13 albums. And it's the everyday practicality of life, with all of its goodness and with even more so maybe its struggle, that moves me closer and closer to becoming who I am. And this is who I am. This is what I do. I'm gonna record again. This album will deal with the earthy mystery that Jesus spoke of. As Jesus says, this world that we're to live in does not rest in certainty. If we built our life around certitudes, would trust have room to stretch its legs and run through our soul? We are pushed deeper and deeper towards the mystery that is way beyond our knowledge and way beyond our understanding. When you choose to contribute to this new album, you're not merely making a financial investment. You're taking ownership of this. This album becomes ours. Yeah, you're gonna get a reward, but your graciousness is gonna far surpass what I can give you in return. So I guess we could conclude that why I'm recording is really not much of a mystery at all. This is who I am. This is what I do. I'm recording again, and I need you.
He is simple. Love's remedy ain't no secret code. Now love's remedy is natural. Just love and faith flow over your soul. Love and feel it flow over your soul. You love and feel it flow over your soul. What you gonna do? What you gonna do?